Aston's channel. So it's been a long time after taking a YouTube video. That's because I have lots of tests going on and it's high school, right? So many homeworks and assignments. Anyways, today I've come up with a short interesting video for you all. And it's nothing about, I'm going to tell you some interesting bio facts. Okay? So anyways, let's get into the video. Now, before I tell you the topic, okay, the topic I'm going to discuss on, let me tell you. Anywhere in your body, if you get a cut, what happens? Blood comes out, right? After 5 to 10 minutes, what do you notice? That the blood gets clotted. The blood gets clotted, right? So, this process, we all know it is blood clotting. But, we always learn that it is blood clotting. But, there's a big chemical reaction. There are so many things that are happening to make this blood get clotted, right? So, let's learn that. So, now you might have got my topic. It's nothing but how does blood clotting occur and everything about blood clotting. Before I start my topic or my about the explanation, let me tell you that calcium, okay, we all know that calcium helps in bringing strong, making our bones and teeth strong, right? But the interest, one more interesting fact that I want to tell you is the calcium ion, this calcium ion helps in blood clotting. You will get to know it when I start explaining. And vitamin K, we all know it helps in blood clotting, right? But why? Because vitamin K produces a substance called as prothrombin. Okay, vitamin K produces a substance called as prothrombin that helps in blood clotting. Prothrombin helps in blood clotting and this prothrombin is secreted by vitamin K. Vitamin K produces prothrombin. Okay, now let me start my explanation. At the site of injury, suppose if here I get the cut, this will be my site of, this will be the site of injury. Okay, at the site of injury, the blood cells, okay, the platelets, okay, the platelets, platelets or the thrombocytes, okay, these thrombocytes get disintegrated. These platelets get disintegrated. Disintegrated means it gets cut. It gets into two parts, okay, it is getting cut, right? This, suppose this is the thrombocyte, it gets cut, okay. So, and when it gets disintegrated, it produces a chemical called as thrombokinase, okay. It produces a chemical called as thrombokinase. Thrombokinase also has one more name, that is, there are many names, one more name I will mention, that is clotting factor 10, okay, clotting factor 10. And this thrombokinase, now we will see the importance of calcium ion in blood clotting. Thrombokinase, in the presence of calcium ion, okay, in the presence of calcium ion, thrombokinase converts prothrombin, okay, prothrombin that is secreted by vitamin K into thrombin. So what happens? Thrombokinase in the presence of calcium ion converts prothrombin into active thrombin. Okay, it converts prothrombin into active thrombin. What happens? Thrombokinase in the presence of calcium ion converts prothrombin into active thrombin. Okay, now this thrombin, what does it do is, thrombin in the presence of calcium ion. Okay, now thrombokinase has converted prothrombin into active thrombin. And this active thrombin, this thrombin in the presence of calcium ion converts soluble fibrinogen, soluble fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin. Okay, it converts soluble fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin. Okay, in the presence of calcium ion, thrombin converts soluble fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin. Okay, and what does fibrin do? Fibrin makes a network or a mesh in the site of the injury. Okay, fibrin makes a network or a mesh or like a net-like structure on the in the site of injury. And what happened? All the blood cells get trapped because the mesh is there. Okay, for example, a mosquito mesh. It doesn't allow mosquitoes to come out like that. There is a very thin net or mesh type formed here. The connection of fibrins are formed here. Okay, that blocks the blood cells to flow. Right. So what happens? The blood cells all stop flowing. It is blocked over there. It is blocked over there. Now what happens is the network. Okay. After some time, what happens? The network that is created, the mesh or net created by the fibrins gets shrunken. Okay. It will shrink because of it's liquid, right? So that mesh, when it gets shrinks, what happens? The rest of the plasma. Okay, the rest of the plasma present over there in the form of clear liquid. Plasma in the form of clear liquid which is devoid of fibrinogen. Okay, plasma in the form of clear liquid, which is devoid of fibrinogen, oozes out. Okay, it comes out. You can see that white color thing after you get blood clot, right? That is this. Okay, plasma which has devoid of fibrinogen. Plasma devoid of fibrinogen oozes out. Okay. As a clear liquid, it observes that a clear liquid. Then what happens? This happens when the bleeding stops. Okay, this process happens when the bleeding stops. Now, the solid mass, sometimes you will find something stuck, right? And when you pull that, again blood will start coming. That is a mesh that is shrunken there. Okay, that solid mass left behind after this process is called thrombus or clot. Okay, thrombus or clot. Clot means thrombus. Its scientific name of clot is thrombus. So this thrombus, what is it? What is thrombus? It's a solid mass left behind after the bleeding stops. Okay? And what the thrombus does, it plugs the injury and thus prevents the further loss of blood. It makes a like a solid mass, it will be stuck there and it plugs the injury. Okay? So that it prevents the further loss of blood and prevents the entry of microorganisms. Blood won't go out, that is good for us. Microorganisms won't come in, that is also good for us. Right? And this is the process of blood clotting. Hope you all enjoyed this video. So, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And many people are watching my video and not subscribing and liking. So, please do like, share and subscribe and support. Okay, so see you all. I might be hope that I will be making a new video soon. So see you everybody. Stay home, stay safe, take care, keep your health good. And okay, see ya, bye. This is Aston Samuel Alexander signing off.